In this section, we're going to create a faceplate called color that will allow us to create some templates for our color controls for red, green, and blue. And then we'll make instances on our detail screen for each of these colors. And finally, in runtime, you'll be able to see how these controls work and how we can control the color strings with our slider. So let's get started. So we're going to start in Graphics Designer. I will choose File, New Type, and it'll create a new faceplate instance. I'll go to Geometry. I'll set my width to 250 and my height 275. Then I'm going to save. We'll save this as color faceplate. Next, I'll grab a static text object to make our header, and I'll just default the text to color and just give it a background color and set my font to white. And I'm going to use my zoom controls to give myself a little bit more room to work. I'll duplicate this. This will be pump, valve, and color strength. I can hit shift enter, takes me to the next line. And I want to drop the font on these, so I will lasso them and just take it down to 18. Also, under styles, I'll make these transparent, and I'll set my line weight to 0 and my font color to red. And let's go ahead and evenly space vertical and left justify. So for our status indicators, I'll duplicate these again. And we want to do an opaque background. And I'll set the font on these to white. So the idea is this is a status indicator. And then I'll just duplicate this. So for a valve, this is going to be open. And for color strength, we need an IO field. Here's an IO field. And the IO field configuration comes up, but we're not going to hook a tag up to it. This is a faceplate. I'll go to fonts, set my alignment, set my font size, and the color strength is going to be an integer, 0 to 255. So under Output Input, I'll just go to Output Format and do that. And then we had a label down here that said it was 0 to 255. So I'll just duplicate one of these, size it, I did a black font, and I think it was italicized. And we're going to put a slider here, so we want to move these objects over. I'm using my arrow keys to move those over. And I will choose a Windows slider object and just put it here. And that will change our color strength. Since it's going to allow us to adjust the color strength, I have to set it to the 0 to 255 range. So our max value would be 255. Min value would be 0. And then we could define the number of steps. So I'll just make that 1. Lastly, we want a fail indicator. And so I'll just duplicate one of these and make it slightly smaller. It's going to say fail, so we will give it a cautionary color. And the idea here is it's just going to overlay this if the fail condition for the pump is there. So we'll do it like that. And then I will duplicate this as well. When we're trying to configure the status indicators, these are going to get in the way. So I'm going to select both my fail indicators and I'm going to put them on a different layer, say layer 2. What this means is I can go down to my layers bar and turn them off so that I can get to them. So I am going to save my work. Next, we need to give good names to all of these objects because later we're going to be picking them out of a list and they all have default names like static text 1, static text 2, as you can see here. So I'll click on the first one, and I'm going to use Hungarian notation so that we can look at the object's name and know what type of object it is and what its purpose is. For this object name, for our label up here, I'll double click, and we will start with a lowercase txt so that I know that it's a text field, and I'll call it color label. That way I can look at that in a list. I know it's a text field and I know it is my color label. So for my pump, text pump label. For my valve, text valve label. Color strength. And then we have this label here. We'll just call that text. Then for our fail indicators, this would be text pump fail indicator. And text valve fail indicator. And then I can turn off my layer to get to these indicators. We will call this text pump state indicator. Text valve state indicator. And I'll turn this back on. And then finally we have our slider. So we'll use SLD color strength, and our IO field. We'll start it with IO, IO color strength. Now when we look at our list of objects, we would easily be able to pick them out of the list and know exactly what they are. So I'll just click save. Now we want to turn this faceplate into a reusable object to allow people to customize it for whichever color system that they're using the object for. We'll click Edit, Configure Faceplate Type. This interface allows us to link properties of the individual objects out to the template so that you can use dynamics and tags on them. Notice that since we've given these all appropriate names, it's easy for us to pick the appropriate objects out of this list. We'll start with our color label. We would need to customize the text of this to put which color that the template represented and also the background color. That is our color label object. So I'll start with a text property, drag it over under properties and let it go. And then we want to give it a name. So I'll right click rename and call this color label text. We also need the back color. So I will grab the back color property and make sure that I put it under the top level properties, and it makes a new property. I'll right click, rename, and call this color label color. Next, we want to add our color strength value, which would go to both our IO field and our slider. So first, I will find the slider. And the property that defines the value of the slider is called process. So I will drop it here. And then we will also find our IO field, and it's the output value that defines what value is shown. And notice we're going to put it in the same place. So this number here is represented both by the slider as well as by the IO field so that we put them under the same place. We'll go ahead and give this a name, color strength. We also want to do our fail indications for pump fail and valve fail. And so for these indications, we're going to turn off the visibility if the failure mode is not active. So we will find our pump fail indicator, which is this yellow box here. And we're just going to grab the visible property, drop it there, rename it, call it pump fail. And we will do the same thing to our valve fail indicator, visible, put it under properties. We also need to do our pump status indicators, which are behind the fail. So we have our state indicator, and we need to be able to get to the text property of that to say if it's on or off. So I'll drop that under properties, rename, just call it pump state text. And then we would also need the color so that we could have it be red or green based on the color. So I'll grab back color, drop it under properties, rename it pump state back color. And then we'll do the same thing with valve. Here's our valve state, rename. Valve state text. Valve state back color. So now we've set properties for all of our visualization controls. And when we're done, we just click OK. It's giving me a message saying that if you've used this previously, they will all be updated and need to be saved. We haven't made it yet, so we're not going to worry about it. And I'll just click yes, and then save. Now we've finished creating our faceplate, and it's time to use it. We're going to use it on our detail screen. I'll get rid of our placeholder text, and then under Smart Objects, find the faceplate instance, and we'll just drag one out. Now it's going to ask us what faceplate we want to connect to, and of course we want to connect to our color FPT. And there's our object. Now notice that we have the object selected. If we look at our properties, those are all the properties that we just configured. So we can treat this like any other object and assign tags or do dynamic dialogues. Since this is going to be our red, then we'll do green and blue. My color label text, I can just edit this directly. Just type in red. Our default color background is red. We don't need to change that. Our color strength is hooked up to both our IO field and our slider. So we'll just hook up our tag. We'll right click, choose tag, and then we'll just hook up our red color strength. For pump fail, this is going to be our visibility. So we just need to hook up our binary tag to this. So we'll right click, tag, red pump fail. Valve fail, we're going to do the same thing. Here is our valve fail tag. For our pump state, we're going to look at our pump on tag. And if it's a one, then it's going to be on. And if it's off, then it's going to say off. So we're going to have to do a dynamic dialog here. So I'll right click, dynamic dialog. Our expression is going to be a tag, pump on. And it's going to be the data type of Boolean. So if the tag is true, it'll say on. So I'll just click here and change this to off. And there's our dynamic dialog. We'll do the same thing on our back color. Dynamic dialog, tag, pump on, and Boolean. So if it's running, then we use red. If it's not running, it's green. So I'll double click, just choose red. And for no, then we'll choose green. We'll do the same thing for our valve state text and valve state color. Right click, dynamic dialog, our valve state, Boolean. And if it's on, then we'll say open. And if it's off, closed. And finally, right click, dynamic dialog. This is for our background color. We'll look at our same tag, Boolean. And then if it's open, it will be red. If it's closed, it will be green. And for this particular object, I'd like to change the name from object faceplate instance 1 to FP color red. Next, we can just duplicate this. And then I will lasso these objects, justify, evenly space. For this one, our color label text is going to be green, and the color label color is also going to be green. Now, we'll need to change all the red instances to green instances, and we can do that with our linking dialog. So I'll right-click, linking, tag connection. I'll go to find and replace and say, find red, replace with green. So we'll select, we'll preview, that looks good, and just hit replace. Now if we look at this, all of our tags have been changed to green, even in the dynamic dialog. So we'll repeat that for blue. Change our color label. And then we will right click and do linking. Look for red. Replace with blue. And make sure we hit replace. We forgot to do the font colors, and we wanted the font colors to be the same thing as the color, but we forgot to do that. So I'm going to show you that faceplates are now global. We'll go back to our faceplate. We will edit and go back to our configuration. We want to go to one of our labels. There's our text pump label, and we will find our four color, which is font. And I'll drop it under properties, rename, and just call it font color. And we've got the pump label. We need to put all of our other labels here for valve and color strength. So here's my valve label. Grab four color. I'll put it under the exact same property. And then we want our color strength label. And we'll put it under there as well. And then I will just click OK. Now it's going to say it's going to update all the pictures containing this faceplate. That's what we want. I'll click yes and then hit save. Now, when we go back, you'll see that we have a new property. So for the red, it's going to stay red. But for green, if I go to font color and give it green, then all my text turns green. Go to blue, choose blue, and there we go. And we're going to save. Now all we need to do is test this in runtime. I'm going to open my main screen and just press runtime. And I'll also bring up my tag simulator. In the tag simulator, we'll need to open the sim file that we saved. So I'll do open. And it'll automatically go to whatever project WinCC has open and just go to the bottom and look for the sim file. And then just start simulation. And then on our detail screen, you should see the different controls working based on what the simulator is doing. And we can control our color strength with our sliders. And then if we go back to our overview page, you can see that those tags are also represented there. So it looks like our detail screen is working.